Hi everybody, it's me again for the latest co-video. I want to tell you my temperature is the same as yesterday and doing well. I imagine that a lot of you are getting very frustrated living at home and getting on each other's nerves. Having been a couple days now, you're with the same people. I'm going to have some news about that. That's actually a good thing that you're with people that are your family. It is a good thing to be with the same people that you're normally with. And I'll show you about that later on. What I want to talk about is on the first slide I have today is about a drug trial that was initiated with some antiviral drugs back in China. This did not work. And again, I'm very pessimistic about a drug solution to our problem. I think it's going to come with immunization and vaccination. I also uncovered a paper that was written about the first person who was exposed to the coronavirus in the United States, the first case. And you can see some of the details of that case on this colorful picture here. It's just showing you the different kinds of information. It's showing you the temperature and the temperature of the person had, whether the person had a fever or not. And you'll see that there is about, you know, several days of a fever, or about really 10 days of a fever, which subsided. And there was a cough that persisted for about really day one all the way out to day 11. A feeling of the runny nose was very minor. Only a two-day runny nose was going on. Fatigue that lasted just one day after the fever went away. Little bit of nausea here and there, a little bit of vomiting and diarrhea. And this is this is patient one from the United States of America. Let me just answer a question right now. This is a question that has been going on, and it's a question that I'll answer every single day, and that is, do you think that social interaction protocols will persist into midsummer, as some are suggesting? I'm only going on the best information I have of today. And I think it will not. My estimations, I've got a team of people working behind the scenes and also private citizen scientists working behind the scenes that are providing me with information. And I think it's going to, maybe last a good six more weeks or so. Now, how we relax the social distancing protocols depend on how good we are and how this works out for us. I want to switch to, you've seen this slide from yesterday showing you the different kinds of viruses, and I want to focus on this word enveloped. Coronavirus is an envelope virus, and what that means, and I'll show you on the next slide here, an envelope virus versus a naked virus, an envelope virus has a membrane around it. And on that membrane comes from the last host the virus was in. Now, here's the part where I'm going to tell you that it's good to be with your family right now, because your family, chances are, and this is one of the things about evolution that we have, families are, people are diverse. Diversity is a great thing. You don't want to be living with people that you could receive an organ donation from. You want them to be a little different. And the reason that you want them to be a little bit different is that you want that. That is a very protective thing. So let me just go to the next slide here and just show you that picture of an envelope virus. And you'll see I've drawn in that thing MHC. MHC is the thing that prevents you from getting organ transplants from anybody. You have to be a match. We have to match you up. So if I need a liver transplant, I can't just go onto Canvas, which is our learning management system at LCCC, and say, wanted liver for transplant will give extra credit. And for those of you in higher ed, you know that that is the most magical word in higher ed. We'll give extra credit. That's a rather hollow offer because there's fine print with it, and it says, must be a match. And there's a good reason that we are not a match. The reason that we are not a match is because that is protective. So if my wife gives me a sneeze bath, I know you guys like that concept, I will be receiving her viruses. And if they're enveloped viruses, they truly are her viruses. And since we live together, we make immune responses, we make antibody responses to each other's proteins, to each other's MHC. And that's how we protect ourselves living in communities. That's one of the things that, that evolution has done for us. And that is a very protective thing. So you kind of, if you got a virus, you want to receive that virus from somebody who is not a tissue similar to you. You want somebody who is not a tissue type as you, and that is a kind of a protective thing. So, you know, one thing I can tell you, yesterday I ordered some exercise bands, and hopefully they will be coming here soon, because we all need to keep fit and keep exercise. I think I might try to take a walk a little bit later on, because, you know, you got to keep yourself healthy, and get outside. Today's nice sunshiny day. Get outside and do something. As always, I'll leave you with this, be good to each other, and find the helpers, and be the helper, and may you persist like a lentivirus.